have my straight skirt, straight short skirt, traced out. The allowance is there, the zip, the side, the one for the waist, and the hem is there. Same thing for the front. So I've traced two patterns because we're treating two styles today. Okay, so we'll start with the A-line skirt. Okay, so a characteristic of an A-line skirt is that it flares out from the waist. Okay, so when you see something that flares out, that means you are adding fullness to that thing. Okay, so how do we get an A-line from our straight skirt pattern? That's what we want to do today. Okay, so the first thing you are going to do is start with the back pattern. Pin out your dart. Okay, how do you pin out your dart? You fold it. You fold your dart. You fold your dart as if you have sewed it already. That's how you fold your dart. Okay, pin it out. Hold it down with a sellotape. Okay, so the distance of your dart, from your zip line, or from your zip line to the tip of your dart, that's about 2.5. So you measure it all the way down. And then you rule it. There. Okay. Once you rule it, that same distance you can use. Because your front doesn't have it, that's 2.5. When you get here, the waist is smaller. Okay. You can use about 2 here. Okay. Rule it. So the tip. Then the next thing you do is to cut it open. So you can see that it opens up to give you the fullness you need. So you do the same thing for the front pattern. So you cut open. To the tip. And then that gives you the, what's it called, the one? So the next thing now is for you to put a paper underneath, or you can go ahead and pin it on your fabric like this. Okay. But since we're doing a miniature, we can put a paper underneath. There you have it. Then you smoothen the M line and cut off the excess paper. There you have your back pattern. Okay, so you do the same thing for the front. So you can decide to measure what this fullness gives you. This is about 1 point. Okay, so the fullness there is 1.5. You can take the paper, measure 1.5. Yeah. Okay, and then gone the front pattern to it. So start from here. I'll start from here. And there you have it. This is your front pattern. Okay. And this is your back pattern. So if you are going to cut now, you are going to place your fabric on bias. You are going to fold your fabric on bias to cut anything that has a flare effect, whether it's a dress or a skirt. It is advisable that you fold your fabric on bias. That means you cut the pattern on the bias grain. Okay. If you are managing your fabric, you can cut it on the straight grain the way I've showed you to place your fabric, but it will not give you the same effect. Okay, if you cut it on the straight grain, you, depending on what fabric you use, you might end up having something sharp as your A-line and it will just stand like that. But if you cut it on the bias grain, it will slip around your body. It has a flare effect, but it won't be as sharp as if you cut it on the straight grain.